Hi, I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. Today, I'm answering a viewer question to talk about déjà vu. I decided to add in information about delusional misidentification because it's a similar phenomenon, but taken to a different level. Déjà vu is French for the term already seen. Déjà vu is the misperception that something new is familiar. It can be a place that you go to and feel like you've been there before, even though you can't recall any details of the experience. So it's not as though you say to yourself, oh yeah, I recognize that red building, so I know I must have been here before. You don't recognize anything. It's more of the sense or just this feeling that you've been here before or experienced it before. It can be a person that you think you've seen before or a conversation that you feel like you've had. And this is a very common phenomenon, and it's related to familiarity-based recognition. The ability to recognize something that you've experienced before is thought to be predominantly controlled by your hippocampus, which is responsible for other types of memory functions. We don't know exactly why this happens in people who don't have an illness or a disorder, but it's hypothesized that it's a glitch in the system where your brain incorrectly matches an experience from a previous memory that's similar and gives and feeds the information to you and gives you the feeling that, oh yeah, I've experienced this before, when you really haven't. It's something similar to what you're currently experiencing. Most times it comes and goes, and it's not a lingering problem that causes distress. There are conditions, though, that can make it happen more. Frequent episodes of déjà vu can happen with temporal lobe epilepsy, and this is where you have abnormal firing of the nerves in your temporal lobe. Your hippocampus is located in your temporal lobe. We have seen some link between episodes of déjà vu and anxiety and depression. Brain scans have shown decreased hippocampal volume in people who have depression, similar to the brain volume loss in people with epilepsy. So there's some data to suggest that if you have depression or anxiety, you may be more prone to experience this, but it would still be occasional and not a predominant experience. So that's déjà vu, a random misapplication of your familiarity recognition ability. A more pathological problem identifying what's familiar and unfamiliar occurs with delusional misidentification syndromes. These are a group of delusional disorders that involve a problem with familiarity. The four syndromes are Capgras delusions, Fregoli delusions, intermetamorphosis syndromes, and syndrome of subjective doubles. Capgras delusion is where a person believes that someone close to them has been replaced by a double or an imposter. This is an example of hypofamiliarity. You don't recognize your loved one as being familiar to you, so you think that it's a stranger that you've never met before. Fregoli delusion has the opposite problem. With this, you're hyper-familiar. You believe that your loved one has been reincarnated into other people. So for an example, you may see a stranger and insist that it's your mother. And because of this, you act inappropriately with the person. Intermetamorphosis occurs when you believe that someone familiar to you has changed into someone else familiar. So you can see your husband as really being your brother. And it's fascinating how the mind works with this. I've talked to someone with this delusion, and you may think, well, can't the person just tell that this person looks nothing like who they think it is? So in this case, what the person sees or saw visually had no bearing on what the belief was, because this is a delusion, and the delusion is not based on gathering data and then coming to a conclusion. It's based on a delusional belief that this is a familiar person, but the person is different from who they think it is. So it doesn't matter that she saw that the person right in front of her was much taller and completely different build and different look. It's almost as though she couldn't even see that part. And when challenged on these details, she would make up a story, or it's as though she could fill in the blanks with explanations like, well, he looks tall, but my husband's tall too. You know, just kind of things that help support the belief that's fixed in her head. It's a very strongly driven belief that has very little to do with what the person actually sees. The last delusion in this quadrant of delusions is subjective doubles. And this is the belief that you have a doppelganger or identical double of yourself living an alternate life. And this is part of the basis of the movie Us. However, in that movie, it wasn't one person's belief. It was the way of the world, that there was a separate alternate life or group of people that were identical doubles of yourself. With this delusion, you're the only person that believes that. All of these delusions are fairly rare, but they are often associated with a neurological disorder like Lewy body dementia or Alzheimer's disease. It's also thought that unlike deja vu, that seems to be a memory problem, that these delusions are more related to abnormal facial processing called visual agnosia. But in the end, they are delusional disorders, and I talk more about delusional disorder and how it behaves in this video. You can take a look to get more information. See you next time.